Eating ice cream?
Eating ice cream. Again?
Why, Nelson Sachs, your daddy got him an audition. I just couldn't pass it up.
You couldn't pass it up? How much ice cream?
He didn't get me any, but I went and got me some myself.
How much ice cream have you had today, Grandma?
Oh, just a little bit. This is non-fattening, I think.
It's non-fattening ice cream?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I believe so. What do you call it?
Well, let me ask you this, Grandma.
Huh?
Would it make any difference?
Oh, yes. I don't want any more calories than I have to take.
I saw you eating ice cream for supper.
Oh, this is Weight Watchers ice cream.
Oh. Does it taste good?
Uh-huh.
Does it taste like the regular ice cream?
It tastes all right to me.
I saw you eating ice cream for supper. What kind was that?
Weight Watchers.
It was Weight Watchers?
Uh-huh.
Okay. Well, did you have a good time this evening?
Yes, I have. I've had a nice time.
That's great.
And talked to Paul.
Uh-huh.
No, I talked to Paul, I guess, where you at, didn't I?
Yes, uh-huh.
Yeah.
Well, I told you that I was going to call you before you left
for
Chicago tomorrow.
Yeah.
And so I just wanted to call and talk to you a little bit before you left.
Uh-huh.
How old are you now, Grandma?
How old am I?
Yeah.
Oh, well. Oh, I'm past my 59.
You're past what?
59.
You're past 59?
Oh, yeah.
By how much?
Like old Bob Hope one time, he said, what did he say? He passed his 30, what? 39, yeah.
Well, you're about 82 now, aren't you?
Oh, you mustn't tell the young men how old I am, because none of them will look at me and be friendly with me.
Oh, I see.
Uh-huh.
When's your birthday coming up?
18th of February.
18th of February?
Uh-huh.
That's not very far away.
Nope.
What do you want for your birthday?
A Cadillac.
A Cadillac.
You know, Melvin asked me what I wanted for Christmas, Melvin Russell, and I told him a Cadillac.
Well, Grandma, when are you going to get old?
When am I going to get old?
Uh-huh.
Oh, about 50 years from now.
About 50 years from now?
Mm-hmm.
Well, when you get older, are you going to go into an old folks' home or what?
No, I intend to just a gab till the good Lord says it's time to come on up.
Uh-huh.
And then I want to go to bed some night, and I want to wake up in heaven the next morning.
What do you think it's going to be like in heaven?
Huh?
What do you think it's going to be like in heaven?
Oh, hallelujah, take old Sheila Cole. I'm going to walk on the streets of gold.
Uh-huh.
Oh, it'll just be wonderful, wonderful. Take old Sheila Cole.
How long do you think that'll be?
Huh?
How long do you think that'll be before you get to go?
Well, I don't know, but, Dwayne, one night I slept good, and I got up, and I walked just as slow and a little bit stiff. I felt a little bit stiff, and I said, Lord, what's the matter with me? And he says, you're getting closer home, closer being with me.
Uh-huh.
And I said, wasn't that cute? I told Nelson, he says, Mama, do you think Jesus is cute?
What about that story of the rocking chair? Are you going to have a special rocking chair when you get to heaven?
Oh, yes.
What was that story? I've kind of forgot.
Oh, a little child asked the grandmother, says, what are you going to do when you get to heaven? And she says, well, if I can get away from the Lord, says, I want to be with him, with Jesus a while. And says, then I'm going to look around, get me a rocking chair, and I'm going to sit down and I'm going to rest for 1,000 years. And says, when that time's up, I'm going to start rocking.
Well, is that what you're going to do, Grandma?
No.
You're too active to sit.
No, I'm not going to sit down. I'm going to explore heaven.
Uh-huh. How many years do you think that will take you to explore heaven?
If I can get away from Jesus, I'm going to explore heaven. I'm going to look around. I'm going to look around, and I'm going to see. And somebody says, do you think you know your loved ones there? I said, I'd hate to be sniffer there than I am here.
How long do you think it'll take you to explore heaven?
Oh, I don't know just exactly.
How big do you think heaven is?
Oh, I think it's just wonderful. And listen, Dwayne, we've worked here for nickels and dimes and dollars all our life, and up there we're going to walk on the streets of gold.
Uh-huh.
Oh. Now, doesn't that make you homesick?
I suppose, but it seems like everything you have here you give away.
Who, me?
Yeah.
Well, listen. Listen, I'm sending my good deeds on up before I go.
Uh-huh.
You see, I heard of an old lady and her husband died and she was rich. He just left her rich. And do you know that her son married and he says, Mom, we could sure use $1,000 mighty good. And she says, we had to work for our money. And she just traveled. She went across the ocean and she's going to take another trip to Russia and she's going to spend it up. But listen, I want to send my good deeds up before I go.
Mm-hmm.
If I could sell my home, well, I'd give each one of the boys, I said, if I could sell that for $15,000, I'd give each three boys $1,000 and I'd keep
$1,000.
Mm-hmm. For $20,000. And the homes are just selling down that block. It's a sight. And they're building such a big home just down, a big storehouse, just the second house down from me. And I told those men, I said, when they got that mansion built down there, they'd come up and build one in my backyard.
Well, what kind of home are you going to have when you get to heaven?
Oh, it doesn't make me any difference. Just anything Jesus puts me in, if it's a tent or anything.
Uh-huh. Are you going to give away everything when you get to heaven, too?
Well, if other people... Now, there's a woman, Miss DeLong, that's up in the hospital now. She told me before she ever went to the hospital, she says, Sachs, when we get to heaven... So you can come into my mansion anytime you want to. So we're going to visit up there.
Mm-hmm.
Just anything he's got prepared for me, I'll take it.
You'll be satisfied, Al.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Well, are you pretty excited about it?
Oh, praise the Lord, yes. Listen, did you open your Christmas card?
Yes, and I want to thank you for that. I was really surprised.
Yes, surprised, Joyce.
You shouldn't have done that, Grandma.
I put a $5 bill in his Christmas card.
Grandma, you shouldn't have done that.
Well, listen, I gave each one of the grandchildren money, and
uh-huh.
Why can't I you? Aren't you mine?
Well, yes, but I'm a grown-up grandchild. I'm a grown-up grandchild now, though.
Well, I don't care if you are. I'll have to tell Judy to help me spank you.
Yeah.
If you don't mind us.
You're going up to visit with Paul.
I'm going up there to... he wanted me to come before Christmas.
Uh-huh.
He said he wanted me to visit a while before Christmas because when they're off from school, why, he's going down to his cabin.
Uh-huh.
Down home. And so he didn't want me to wait till the 19th and come.
Yeah.
So he wanted me to come before.
Now, Paul is your favorite son, isn't he?
No, I don't know if he is.
You don't know that he is? That's what Paul's always told me.
He stayed home longer than any of them.
Uh-huh.
He's my baby boy.
Yeah.
Do you know, 6'2" tall, and when he was up one time, I went up to Boston. They got a new clerks up there. They didn't know him. And I said, this is my baby boy, Paul.
Yeah.
Baby boy.
Well, Paul always told me that that he was your favorite son.
That's his idea, huh?
Yeah. That's what he's always told me. I wonder how he got that idea.
Well, he's the last one that left. And, at first I couldn't help but just cry. Because there's me and Daddy sitting there, no children at home or anything. And I wrote to him and I said, Paul, I just quit crying anything about you. And he says, Mom, don't you love me anymore? But it was lonely after he left, you know.
Yeah. What do you think of your other two sons?
Well, I just think they're wonderful.
Uh-huh. Which one is the most wonderful?
My preacher son and Melvin Sachs. And just think, now, the Lord sure has prospered them and helped them. Spiritually, physically, and temporally. Now, Melvin used to be just a boss there in the gospel publishing house. And then the main engineer up above him retired, and they put him up there in his place.
Mm-hmm.
And he's way up there over, I guess, more than 80 people.
I think you always referred to Melvin as the lawyer's son, didn't you?
Well, yes. You know, he told me one time. He says, Mom, you're always talking. He says, about your preacher son. Your preacher son. And Virgie Allenberger, or Virgie Brown, if she joined in with Paul, she just thinks Melvin's just about it, because Melvin goes here, I guess, the office and the others does. And she says, Mary, you always do say your preacher son. And I said, well, I've just gotten the habit of saying that, you know, so they'll know who I'm talking about,
mm-hmm.
My preacher son. And I wrote and told Melvin, I says, I don't just have a, just only have a preacher son. I have a lawyer son. I says, he'll tell me what I ought to do and what I shouldn't do. One time I was down at the lake and I wanted to get one of those big boats, you know, what do you call them?
Speedboat?
Of what, Joyce? Yeah, pontoon.
A pontoon
boat. Oh, I'd love to ride on those. And Melvin says, now, Mama, he says, you couldn't do that. You'd have to winterize it and everything. You'd have to have some place to store it, place to put it away. Everything says, you can do that. And I thought that was pretty wise.
That's true.
Yeah, yes, he'll tell you what you ought to do and what you shouldn't.
Well, tell me this, Grandma.
What?
What do you think of your grandchildren?
My grandchildren? I think they're wonderful.
Uh-huh. What do you think about each one? Doug, for example. What do you think about him?
Who?
Doug.
Douglas?
Yeah.
Well, listen, he and I, a year or so ago, we went out for a walk. And I said, Douglas, they say you shouldn't tell young people what they should be when they get grown up, you know. And I said, Douglas, when you get to be a big boy, what are you going to do? Grown up man. He says, Grandma, he says, I guess I'll be either a doctor or a bread man. He's going to help the public, wasn't he?
Uh-huh. What about Misty?
Oh, she's a musician. She's going around different places and with the choir in different places and sings and plays her music. Yeah, I think she's a nice girl.
Have you heard her play her violin?
Yeah.
Uh-huh. She's growing up, isn't she?
Oh, yes. And our last year, she just worked so hard, and it was getting lessons, and it was music, taking her music lessons and everything. And she cut out something this year, Cheryl told me, that she couldn't keep up with all of us.
What do you think of Sherilyn?
Oh, she's a smart little booger. Listen, do you know what? She was one among four of the smartest in her school last year. And they didn't want to tell her. They afraid she wouldn't study much.
Mm-hmm.
And one day, Paul said to her, says, Sherilyn, you're sure a smart little sax. She says, yes, but you must remember, I wasn't a sax. She says, I was a doctor's daughter. Now, wasn't that something?
Uh-huh.
She thought she got her smartness from that doctor.
Uh-huh. What do you think of Carolyn?
Carolyn? Well, I guess she's going to be pretty smart, but she seems like a little wildcat for a while.
What do you think she is now?
Oh, she just fancy and just do different things.
You think she's going to get very big?
I don't know.
But maybe you can feed her some ice cream when you go up there.
Yeah, I guess so. And, you know, I stayed with her. I stayed with them when she was a baby. From November to June, I believe it was, till school was out. And I took care of her. Bathed her and fed her and everything. Stayed right there with her. And do you know that she just, I better stay up, feed her, and better play till she's tired. And she wanted to lay down and go to sleep. Then when Jacqueline come home, why, she's in her hand. And do you know that she'd put her to bed of the evening and just let her squall it out, and I couldn't understand it.
Mm-hmm.
It wasn't my say. It wasn't my doings. But I think that if you leave them up till they play and they're really tired, they'll go to sleep right now.
What do you think of Aaron?
Aaron?
Yeah.
Why, he's just getting to be a grown-up boy. He's just lots better, I think, than he was for a while.
Uh-huh.
He doesn't act so childish anymore.
Uh-huh. What about Joyce?
Well, Joyce is just she's the number one young lady.
She's the number one young what?
Yes, she's sitting here at the dining table getting her lesson.
Uh-huh.
Oh, yes, she's going to be a smart Alec. No, I mean, she's really going to be a smart girl.
Well, what do you think of your oldest grandson?
My oldest grandson?
Yeah.
Well, I just think he's wonderful, too.
You think they're all wonderful, don't you?
Yes. And I just hope that he's got lots of patience with those poor boys. Oh, that he has to... Do you have to see him every day?
Well,
huh?
No. Not all of them every day.
Uh-huh. I feel so sorry for them. Just think maybe they haven't had any teaching or training, and they just growed up just doing anything the devil wanted them to do.
Grandma, we're going to have a problem when you go up to heaven. Do you know that?
Why?
Well, we're all going to miss you so much. You bring so much life into everybody's life.
Joyce, and what he said, my precious Lord. Well, you just thank the Lord for that. He said that when I went up to heaven, you know, so I missed me because I lost so much life and happiness. Why, Duane, you don't thank old Grandma Mary. You just thank Jesus.
Uh-huh. Well, what do you think we all should do?
Well, just thank the Lord. Because I say that if I ever do anything good to anybody, kindness or anything, well, they just need to thank the Lord. It's not old Mary. It's just him put that love within my heart and mind.
Mm-hmm.
It'd be better to say, well, she's gone up and she was good, than to say, well, she's a mean old devil. I'm just laughing about that.
Well, it's going to be hard to have a party, though.
Hard to have a party?
Yeah, because you won't be with us, you'll be with Jesus.
Oh! We'll
want you back with us.
Well, if I'm with Jesus, well, that's just, that will be wonderful. That'll be the happiest I've ever been in all my life.
Is that right?
Oh, praise God. I told somebody I was packing up, getting ready to leave. And I said, some of these days, I wasn't going to have to pack up all that junk. I was going without packing. Yes, Duane, every night I'll ask the Lord if I've said or done anything, thought anything I shouldn't, to forgive me. Because I may be asleep when he comes, and I want to be ready to go with him.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. That's when you want to go when you're asleep, huh?
Oh, no, but, you know, I stayed with the lady down here. 3 blocks down below Nelson's church one time, Miss Gamble. And, when I went there, she wanted to, she didn't want me to pray or nothing. And I said, well, Miss Gamble, I said, I pray every night. I said, I ask the Lord to forgive me if I've said or done anything that wouldn't be acceptable with him, because he may come while I'm asleep, and I want to be ready to go with him. And she said, oh, I don't bother him about every little thing. And, you know, I got so that I'd pray a little bit. I'd kiss her on the forehead after I took her in bed, and she got so she thanked me for it.
Well, what do you want your 3 sons to do after you've gone to heaven?
After I've gone to heaven?
Yeah.
Live for the Lord and do just what he wants them to do. All my grandchildren and my sons too. My daughter-in-law.
That's all you want them to do?
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir. Do just, and you know the Lord will speak to you, and he'll put within your heart and mind just what to do. And you know that the Lord, he wants first place in your life, not second or third place. And every time that I went against old Mary's will, something great has happened.
You know, Grandma, I have a feeling that when you go on to heaven, that you're going to be coming back occasionally and talking with us.
Well, I sure like to.
I think you probably will be. What do you think you'll be telling us?
If the Lord would just let me come back and you just dream that I was talking to you, I'd be saying something about Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll tell you what heaven was, too.
Mm-hmm.
Praise the Lord.
You'd probably be laughing some, too, I imagine.
Huh?
You'd probably be laughing some, too.
Laughing?
Uh-huh.
Why, sure.
You think they're going to have ice cream in heaven?
In heaven? Well, Joyce, he won't know if we're going to have ice cream in heaven. Well, listen, we're going to have something greater than ice cream. Joyce says if they got refrigerator, said we'd find it.
That's probably the first thing you'll look for after you find Jesus. You'll be sitting beside Jesus with a gallon of ice cream in your lap.
A gallon of ice cream in my lap. Bless his heart. Now, listen, Jesus hears every word that we say. Do you think he'll think this is wise or if we're talking silly?
Well, I know when you have some ice cream, you have a piece of heaven right there.
Oh, praise the Lord. Duane, you don't know how thankful I am that I can gather around and go like I do, and the children's always been so nice to me. Now, Melvin phoned and told me, he said, mark on your calendar the 20th of November. That's the day I want you to come up. So I went up there and I stayed a week. You want me to stay for Thanksgiving? And then I got home, somebody says, now where are you going for Christmas? And I said, I don't know. I don't have any plans. Maybe I'll be at home. I don't know. And there Paul called me and he says, Mom won't come to Waukegan. Won't you come up before Christmas, too? And I thought I'd wait till the 19th and come down here. They're going to have dinner 20th. And so he said, no, not to wait that long. He said he wanted me to be up there and visit a while, because just as soon as they got home from school, and we spend Christmas up there, he wants to go down to his cabin at the lake, you know, and said he'd bring you home. And that's the way things go. And then, Nelson Marjorie came by. They was going to have me come down here for Christmas.
Well, you had all kinds of invitations.
Yes.
You're wanted by everybody, Grandma.
Oh, praise the Lord.
Because you're so much alive. You got so much life in you.
Well, it's not old Mary, it's just Jesus. I just give him all thanks for everything.
Well, he seems to give you a lot of power to keep you going, I can say that.
Well, that's right. I'm so glad. But Duane, you go in those rest homes and you see people sitting in wheelchairs, and some are crippled and laying down beds and different things, and you ought to be glad that you can get up and walk around. And I get on the bus and go anywhere I want to,
mm-hmm.
there in Jefferson City. I have a ticket, you know, I can go on the bus anywhere.
Mm-hmm.
And don't have to pay, just get one ticket the first December, and lasts all year.
You're going to be 83 and you can get anywhere you want to go, huh?
Oh, they wanted to know a while ago, somebody wanted to know how old. I said, well, didn't Bob Hope say he's 39 years old? I said, I'm past 39.
Well, you're getting ready to go to Chicago tomorrow, aren't you?
Yeah.
What time are you leaving?
Well, we have to get up here early in the morning. Margie phoned the depot, and this one goes real late, and Paul said that he couldn't meet that one because he'll be in a meeting, business meeting or something tomorrow night, and he didn't want to Jackson drive over to Chicago because he says they've got the 4 inches of snow, and it's going to have 2 more tonight.
My goodness.
That's what he said.
Well, you have a long trip ahead of you. Maybe you'll have a chance on the train to witness to someone tomorrow.
Margie gave me a whole handful of tracts, and it was about salvation. He told me the scriptures and everything to find. And do you know that I gave those to people? And I said, well, whatever church you're going to, I said, that'll teach you just exactly how to be saved. And I said, if you're born again, you can go to heaven out of any church. You've got to be saved, though.
That's right.
That's what Jesus said.
Well, I better let you get to bed so that you can get on your...
Well, Wayne, it was really nice talking to you.
It was great talking with you, Grandma, and I want to
wish... And you tell Judy that I said goodbye, and God bless you both.
Okay, I want to wish you a Merry Christmas.
Well, same to y'all.
And I want you to have a good trip up to Chicago and tell Paul and Jackie we said hi.
Uh-huh. All right.
And you just had a good time up there now.
All right, I sure will. God bless you.
Good night, Grandma.
There's so much time to listen and so much time to be heard. We must all stand in the water. We must find it when we roar. Don't matter what it says, we can wake up from the dead and roll away the stone. We can roll away the stone. Hallelujah, we must all stand in the water. We must find it when we roar. It don't matter what it says, we can wake up from the dead and roll away the stone. We can roll away the stone. Lord, Lord, we must all stand in the water. We must find it when we roar. It don't matter what it says, we can wake up from the dead.